Hi everyone, so welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to analyze Infosys. So here if you see, this is a daily chart of Infosys and it is almost at all-time high. Okay, I'm going to analyze this only and only from investment perspective. Okay, before I initiate my analysis, let me check on to the Nifty IT index. So here it is following this trend line. This is a daily chart. There was this correction which was in this pandemic, and then if you see, there was a huge upside. Okay, right now it is at all-time high. Okay, if I go on to a monthly chart, it is at all-time high. So eventually, if you see that, if you are building your portfolio, okay, at the end of the day it has to go up. Okay, it is going up. It is making a higher low formation, right? So until we are not breaking this trend line as of now, we should be staying long with the IT stocks, right? So now if we see onto, let's say, Infosys, again I'll start with my monthly time frame, and again if you see, if I draw a horizontal line over this, if you see, it is following a higher low formation, and it is not breaking that pattern. Okay, it is not breaking that pattern. So for me, the next time whenever my stock is going to come below, this will be my first support. Now the reason is because it broke this resistance. There was a very good correction. It broke this resistance and it went onto the upside. Right now, I'll also tell you why. Okay, so now before I initiate this, let me also check on to daily demand, monthly. No, so there is no demand as of now. Onto a weekly chart also, there was this demand, green and blue and green, so it has already reacted, it went up. Okay, again there is this demand which is very far, so I'm not going to talk about that right now. Okay, right now it is at 1163. Okay, now let me go on to a daily chart as well. Okay. So first is weekly chart, or maybe let me try monthly chart only first. Yes, right. So let me get rid of this. And now if you see, I'll draw a Fibonacci, which is the tool which I use. So if you see, it went up, there was this resistance, it came down and it retraced to around 78.6, and exactly there was a reversal. Okay, so there was a very huge buying. One, on the other side, if I zoom this, you see there is a red, blue, green. So this is a drop, base, rally, and it was coinciding with the Fibonacci retracement level, which is 78.6, right? So for me, again, it was a blind buy. Okay, whenever you are able to see any zone which is coinciding with something else, you should go, and you should, because the probability of working of that demand or that level is on a higher side. And from that perspective, I'm saying that this was the very good level to go long. So this is one. Another is, let's say if I try to draw a Fibonacci retracement. Let's say if I draw this from here to here. Right. So now if you see from one to here, because this was a correction, A, B, and C. So this was a correction. And then if you see, it went on to till 2, which is 1189. So in this candle itself, it went on to 1189. It came down and now again it is going up, right? So I'm assuming, and by looking at the price structure, it clearly looks like this is going to break this level at this time. Okay, one. And on the other side, I have this level now, which is the next level, which is somewhere around 1400, right? Which is the next level. So that is the one which I'm looking for right now. Okay, one. So for me, my target from a long-term perspective as of now is 1401. Now, if I go on to a, let's say, daily chart, okay, now if you see on a daily chart, I have this trend line which is still intact, okay, this trend line, or let me draw this trend line from here, okay, and this way, right? So now this is the trend line which is being intact, this is also another one which is still working fine, okay. I would call this as a ascending symmetrical triangle breakout, okay. So as of now we have not broke, but then I'm expecting that it should go like this, okay. This is one. On the other side, let's say if I go on to a lower time frame, on a, let's say, 4 hour chart, okay. So if you see, there is this level, and if I try to draw a head and shoulder pattern, okay, like this, then it is giving me a head and shoulder pattern, which is something like this, right? So this is on a 4 hour chart. I'm holding one position of entry, and that is I'm holding a call of 1200 option, and that too for the month of Jan, okay, just to be on a safe side. So I'm expecting a big rally in entry. So from a trading perspective, my first immediate target is 1260, right? Now if you see, the volume, one concern for me is the volume. The moment it gave a breakout over here, there was very low volume. It went on the upside, again it came down, again there is a very low volume. If I go on to a daily time frame, so the volume is quite okay for here, but then there was a, but then yes, there is a volume contraction, right? But the concern again, one is there's this huge candle and the volume was very high, the way it was this one. But if you see, the volume was very high for this candle, and for this candle the volume was very low, and right now we are almost at near resistance, and I have seen this pattern. And also from the other perspective, I'm expecting Infosys to go up. Again, I want Infosys to give me a close above 1183, somewhere around here, which is, I think, the recent high. Yeah, somewhere around here, or maybe right, yes. So let it give a close about this, and I think maybe by next week we should expect a rally in Infosys. And then the moment it gives you a close above 1180 or 86, it should, you know, give a very fast move. And again, this should be, you know, kind of add-on for Nifty to give some move upside. So this is one target for me. This 1260 is something which I'm expecting on Infosys, and that is only and only from trading perspective. Okay, from the other perspective which we already discussed, let me get rid of this. So on a higher time frame, okay, we have seen that it has reacted, on a Fibonacci it has reacted, and exactly this is already done. So the next target which I'm expecting on a higher time frame after 1400, which we already got, is this one, which is 1600, right? So I would say, that CMP for Infosys is 1163. I'm expecting a target of 1260, 1400, and 1600. For me, the stop loss would be, let me get rid of this. Again, this target, which is 1600, is only and only from portfolio perspective, not from trading perspective. Okay, and let me get rid of this, and weekly, okay. So I was again expecting that just a moment, right? So considering that we are in third wave, okay, ideally we should not go below this level, which is 851. On the other side, I'm expecting that maybe we should retrace somewhere around here, which is 1000 in case if there is a fall. Again, in case if there is a huge fall, maximum it can go till 900 levels. Okay, again, that is only and only from portfolio perspective, right? This was a monthly chart. Let me see if we have something over here. So we have this demand which was already worked. If I go on to a daily chart, so there was this demand which worked very beautifully. If you see green, blue, green, and there was a very huge gap which was covered with a demand, and then it worked. So again, I'm expecting that the next time whenever it will come over here, ideally it should not go below this level, which is 1000 level, right? So again, for me, I would say that if you want to initiate a trade, 1050 should be your stop loss for Infosys. So 1050 should be your stop loss. Current market price is 1163. So I think there's a risk of almost 110 points if you want to go long from the portfolio perspective. And the target for you is somewhere around 1260, which is for me, at least from the trading perspective, this is my first target, which is a head and shoulder breakout. The other one is 1400 and 1600. So this is the level which I'm expecting on Infosys. Okay. You can do your own analysis. You can also keep on track, keep tracking this level, which is this one, that ideally it should not go below this trend line. And again, even if it is going below, it should not close below this trend line, which is very important, because that is the trend line which has been formed. And the very third time whenever it will come over here, ideally you should keep on adding. If you want to average, you can average at this level, because I am expecting that it should not go below this level. In case if it is going below this level, you can take exit from the trade, right? Because you already have a stop loss which is already defined, right? So that was my view on Infosys. I'm expecting that the stock is going to touch somewhere around 1600 from the portfolio perspective. Stop loss is 1050, and again, you can keep it for your portfolio at least for a 1 year, and you should get a very good return from this, right? So thank you for watching this video. Do comments if you have any doubts or any queries on this. Fine. Thank you so much.